Father René Laurentin, a well-known theologian, teacher, and great author, having won many awards for his writings. He is a pioneer of the methods of theological investigations, approved by the Vatican II Council. He was one of the founders of the Vatican II Council. He holds a double doctorate in history and theology. He is known also for his scientific search for the truth and authenticity of mystics.
Sure, my opinion is positive on Vassula, but I have to precise that for the Church, the revelation is the Gospel, the revelation of Christ. After that, after the Gospel, there are only private revelation, and very difficult to appreciate, and never the Church considered a posterior revelation to a saint like a new revelation. It is the free service of the faith, it is the freedom of the Christian to believe or not believe the private revelation. For me it's very important, this discernment of the private revelation, because it is the life, the daily life of the Church. And for this reason, I was interested to the message of Vassula. When she came to me by France, the first time when some person called me saying, we were converted by this message, our life has changed, I tried to understand. And when I gave a document to introduce the message of Vassula, it was not a preface, I only gave an interview saying, who was Vassula? And I think, so the little facts I noted, it seemed to me that everyone could understand that she was sincere, that she had a very original experience. She hoped to live with Christ alone. This is very original because few persons of the world would say that. And if you read the preface in the Messages of Vassula, you will find many things like that. And after that, during many years, I could follow her, I could see some more special experiences. For example, during 1 year, or a little more, the Friday, Vassula shared the passion of Christ. She could live all the passion of Christ, and she suffered as a Christ terribly. And I was present once to this experience. It would be many things to say. And for me, perhaps the last, not least thing, is when she was so persecuted by many persons, some Orthodox in Greece, because they said she's too Catholic, and by many Catholic, but she said she's not Catholic, and so on. And Vassula was very calm, very peaceful in that. When you are persecuted, generally you are not calm. And so calm after many times, and Vassula has a sensibility, she's a woman, she has a sensibility, but now she lives so much with God, with Christ, that she is like an insensibilization. And she said to me, very spontaneously, now with all of that, I don't suffer so much, and as Christ suffered very much for the salvation of the world, I have also to suffer. What will can invent God, because I must to suffer? This sincerity for me seemed to me very characteristic, because I know in the Catholic Church many victim soul, as they say, person who live all their life the passion of Christ in many manners, and suffering is a terrible thing, not understandable thing. And this peace before the suffering, this desire of suffering, not by masochism, by love of suffering, but by love of God, love of man, love of humanity, for me is a great sign of holiness and of authenticity.